Welcome everyone. Today we're looking at creating an audio using H5P on WordPress. Very simple, there's not much to it, so all we can create is an audio. So we upload a local file or a link and it creates an audio player. You can play the audio, you can control the volume, you can download and you can scrub through the audio file. There are a few different players that you can use and we will go through all of them, but this is the main one, or this is the one that I chose to use. So this is a standalone module, but you can include it in an interactive workbook, maybe in a presentation as well. Let's take a look at how we can create an audio or add an audio using H5P on WordPress. Let's get started creating an audio using H5P on WordPress. So what you want to do is come down to your H5P content and you want to add new. And from the module list, you want to find audio, or you can just type it in the search. So this is the audio module that we're looking at today. You can click on get if you don't have it. If you already have it, you can just click on it to add this module. Give it a title, we'll call it audio. And what you want to do is you want to upload your audio file. You can use a link from a website, or you can upload your own file. I've got a video file that I'm gonna upload. So this is a local audio file instead of finding a link or having an external link. So it's uploaded. And then I choose the player mode, which is basically what it will look like. So we have minimalistic, full, or transparent. And we'll look at all of them. And we're gonna fit to wrapper so that it fits the container or the wrapper that it's in. And enable autoplay, we will not enable autoplay. That will just autoplay the audio as soon as the page is open. And let's just take a look at what the minimalistic audio player looks like. Okay, so that basically fit the audio button into the wrapper, just making it look like not that great. We can still click on it, it should play. Okay. So we know we don't want to fit to wrapper. Let's look at what it looks like without fitting it into the wrapper. Should just look like a small icon there. But for this one, I think it's too small, very difficult. Plus there's really no instruction or text that you can add. You would have to do it within your website, not within this activity. So unless it's something not that important, like extra information that you can have, you can use the minimalistic. You can also have the full player. And this is what the full player looks like. If I was to fit this into the wrapper, it would start here and it would end at the end of this window or this box right here. And you have play, you have download, and you have control over the volume, and you have a scrubber that goes through. So that's a little bit more visible, more control for the user. And finally, you have a transparent. So this transparent player, very specific use cases. You can't see it. So what this is usually paired with is autoplay. So you have a transparent audio file and you have enable autoplay. That way, as soon as that activity is loaded, the audio will play and it will seem like it's playing in the background. There is no button you click to play it. There are no controls. So I'm gonna try this right now and see what it looks like or what it sounds like. Okay. So as you can see, it auto-played the audio as soon as I updated. So it was transparent with enabled autoplay. Just be careful with this feature, using it in this way, because modern browsers are moving towards giving users more control and not allowing auto-playing audio on browsers, because that kind of takes away from a user's control. They want the user to approve anything that happens on the browser, like audio or video playing automatically. So this would be cool. So if you had an the way you can use this in this way, transparent with autoplay enabled, is if you had an activity and you just wanted to have maybe some background music, or you want something to be played once only and not replayed, then you can use this this tool in this way. But what I think most people will use it, or how they will use it, is probably using a full player with enabled control, or maybe you can disable the controls. Again, this is still auto playing. Probably not the best idea for any activity, because usually someone needs some time to settle in before they click on start. Let's not enable controls, and we'll have a full audio player. This is what it looks like. Nothing, because there are no controls and it's not auto playing. So my suggestion, or at least the way I use it actually, is I use full, I use enable audio or enable control, and that's basically it. So it could be just like an audio embedder. If you just want to use it in that way, that's fine. And that's how it works. To get this on your website, you want to copy the short code and you want to add a new post or a new page. So add new, add a new post. Give this a title, call it audio, and you want to add a new block, and this new block has to be a short code block. So you can paste your short code into it, that way WordPress knows how to read it. And then you want to publish. Yes, publish, and let me view my post to see what it looks like. Very basic, very simple right here. I've got my controls enabled as well, and I can download the audio if I wanted to. So I think there are two main ways you can use this module. Is if you just wanted to embed quick audio into your website, you can use this. So you can use a full player, or you can use just a button, or you can even use a transparent, something that plays in the background, transparent player. So you can use those ways to just put audio into your website. But you can also, this is the second main way of using this, is to use it in a in an activity, like an interactive workbook. You can add an audio, and it would be using this module to add the audio. So you can either add the audio within the interactive workbook, or you can create the audio and then copy it from the external module and paste it into the interactive workbook. So if you had a library of audio and you wanted to keep some nice, you wanted to keep nicely organized, you can create them in external modules. And then when you create interactive workbooks, you can just copy the external modules and paste them into your interactive workbook. That would be the best way to do it. Okay, let me know if there are any other ways to use this for any other reasons. Let me know if you have any comments, any ideas. Otherwise, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.